defense attorneys Janet Johnson joining us here in studio. Darren Kavanocki is also joining us remotely. Christy Paul, HLN anchor, is here. And, of course, Mike Brooks still with us. Let me start here with this is bad.
Oh.
You're talking about the trust with the doctor, but let's start from your perspective first, Christy Paul. I mean, how invasive, how bad is this?
Well, look, I mean, for a woman, it's all, and especially in her case, it was already so horrendous because she was dealing with a miscarriage and the possibility of a hysterectomy, as he said. But it can be uncomfortable anyway for a woman to go to a doctor, especially one she doesn't know. So I have to, one thing that he said that really stood out to me was that she felt uncomfortable, and I have to give her utmost credit for going with that gut feeling and paying attention to what was going around her. And that's one of the things I think that we need to keep in mind when we go to a doctor. But you are in the most vulnerable position at that moment because you have no clothes on and you're allowing this person to examine you. So it is a violation of the utmost.
And it's not equal footing. I mean, you know, you're already submissive because it's a doctor and you're nervous that he's going to give you bad news. So you have to, you know, fulfill whatever requirements he asks you to do so that you get the right diagnosis. I mean, it's a scary, there's no balance of power there to begin with. But that's why the nurse is in there. And that's what I think is so interesting, because when I have clients who put themselves in these positions professionally, I've had, you know, masseuse in the same position. Now they have people come in the room just to protect themselves. This woman, this nurse, was not in the room when he did it. And I wonder how often that happened, because that's very unusual.
Right. Now, Mike, the other part of this is trying to track down other potential victims.
Right, forensics.
How are you going to do that? I mean, I guess one way is a client list, right, or a patient list?
Yeah, exactly. They'll know who was in for certain days for certain appointments, and hopefully they can go back and take these photos that he thought he had deleted. And many times you will go back and it will have a date associated with that particular photo. So maybe they can go back and kind of narrow down who these other pictures are, you know, depending on what kind of phone he had, this kind of thing. But I'm sure that forensically they hopefully can be able to do that.
But with HIPAA, I'm not sure they can. I mean, the patients, even though it's ironic because their privacy is not protected, obviously, but they have a right not to have their identity protected as patients of that doctor. So I don't know if they can do that.
Well, but there was a crime committed here, so then they have to go back now. And, you know, and HIPAA, I think, might not be applicable in this particular situation.
This is just trying to track down who it is. Investigation. The other difficult part is this is a small town and there's not a ton
of
OBGYNs, and these women need help. All right, you have the right to a trial by jury of your peers. Does this German Shepherd count as your peer? Legal insanity next.
Let me ask you, have you liked Betty Crocker on Facebook or maybe Cheerios? Guess what? You may have just given up your rights to sue the company that makes them.